So after some time, Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda came to visit Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida.
And
when they came there, they brought with them their son, Lord Krishna. So Lord Krishna was crawling around, and he came crawling in front of the cradle or the cot where Srimati Radharani was laying in her form as a young baby.
So Krishna, 就在大人讲话的时候，爬到这Radharani那个房间，就是Radharani还躺在摇篮上的时候。And
as soon as Lord Krishna came in front of Srimati Radharani, then immediately she opened her eyes.
Krishna爬到Radharani的前面的时候，Radharani马上就把眼睛张开了。
So Lord Krishna was the first person she ever saw.
所以 Krishna 呢是她所见到的第一个人。
And it said, Srimati Radharani, she doesn't look at any other man.
而且是这样说的 ，Radharani 从来不看其他任何的男子。
So she's the most chaste of all ladies.
她是在所有女子中最贞洁、真诚的。
So.She has many wonderful qualities which attract her to Lord Madhava.
那 Radharani 呢有非常多的品质来吸引着 Madhava.
Lord Madhava is attracted to Srimati Radharani, not just because she has a nice hairdo or anything.
Madhava 受到 Radharani 的吸引，不是说 Radharani 的头发怎么漂亮，或是她怎么样装扮的。
But he's attracted by her wonderful cooking.
但是他受到她非常绝棒的这个烹饪。
Srimati Radharani had received a benediction from Durvasa Muni.
那这个 Radharani 曾经受到 Durvasa Muni 这个圣人的祝福。
Durvasa Muni, you know, is a Sometimes he exhibits passion or the krodha potency, the anger potency, which sometimes is seen by people in the renounced order.
Durvasa Muni 呢展示很多种不同的品质，有时候呢他是有时候甚至展示出愤怒的这个情况，那有时候他要展示非常怜悯的这种情况。
No.I said, no, I didn't say that at all. I didn't mention any compassion. Where did you get it from? I said, sometimes they will display the anger. People in the renounced order sometimes get angry.
就是说他有时候展示愤怒的情况，有时候在气绝的人中呢，他们展示出愤怒。
So Durvasa had that tendency that he would get sometimes angry with people and curse them.But when Radharani, when Srimati Radharani cooked for him, she cooked very nicely and he was very pleased.
因为有时候人们在做饭的时候做得不好，那 Durvasa Muni 会很生气，然后愤怒地去纠正他们。但是 Radharani 在煮的时候呢，煮得非常好。
So he blessed her that everything she cooked would be like nectar.
所以呢，这个 Durvasa Muni 就祝福他，他所做的一切呢，都会所煮的烹饪是非常完美。
So Mother Yashoda, she knew that Srimati Radharani had this blessing from Durvasa Muni, so she arranged that Srimati Radharani every day would come and cook for Lord Krishna.
那 Yashoda 母亲呢，她知道呢 Radharani 得到这个祝福，所以呢，她知道 Radharani 有这项祝福，所以她就安排 Radharani 每天可以过来为她就是做饭，为 Krishna 做饭。
So when we make offerings for Srimati Radharani, like you know, we should be doing today and probably tomorrow also, you know, we want to make a very special effort to prepare very nice, tasty, nourishing, attractive foodstuffs.
所以呢，当像我们在对 Radharani 做供奉的时候，像今天啊，甚至明天啊，就是要做非常好的这种料理，这样准备给他供奉。
So Srimati Radharani is expert cook and she's also very expert in dancing. Lord Krishna likes to dance. We all know he dances Rasa Lila with the gopis. So Srimati Radharani gives great pleasure to Krishna when she dances with him.
Radharani 不只善于烹饪，而且她非常的善于舞蹈。那我们知道 Krishna 是非常喜欢舞蹈，当这个 Radharani 她跳得这么好，所以 Krishna 也是觉得非常的喜乐。
So these are the two of all the other qualities. Srimati Radharani has many, many wonderful qualities, but these are two particular qualities which are very attractive to Lord Krishna.
那这我们提到只有两个品质 ，Radharani 有非常多非常多的品质在吸引着 Krishna.
And here, this song is written by Srila Rupa Goswami, by the way. Sri Rupa Goswami was one of the principal disciples of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
像我们刚唱对 Radha Rani 的这个赞美荣耀呢，是 Rupa Goswami 所写的。Rupa Goswami 呢是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的一个主要的门徒。
And here it's mentioned how Srimati Radharani is worshipped by all the young girls of Gokul.
这里呢，描述到 Radha Rani 怎么样受到这个 Gokula 那边的年轻女孩子的崇拜。
Because they know that all the young girls of Gokul know that Srimati Radharani is the eternal consort of Lord Krishna.
因为在 Gokula 这些年轻的女孩子都知道呢 ，Radha Rani 是Krishna 的一个永恒的伴侣。
And they seek the blessings of Srimati Radharani.
所以呢，这些女孩子就请求这个 Radha Rani 的祝福。
Just like we often hear in Vrindavan, people say Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe.
就像我们呢，在 Vrindavan 听到人们会说，哦 ，Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe 这样喊着。
Because they're seeking the blessings of Srimati Radharani. If Srimati Radharani will be pleased with them, then she can introduce them to Lord Krishna.
因为他们在祈祷着，希望得到 Radha Rani 的祝福啊。因为呢，如果可以取悦 Radha Rani 的话，才可以去接近 Krishna。
If we want to meet Krishna, to get close to Krishna, we need to have the blessings of Srimati Radharani。
所以，如果我们要接近 Radha Rani 的话，我们就需要有这个接近 Krishna 就需要 Radha Rani 的祝福才可以。
So sometimes.Devotees wonder, well, we should also be chanting the names of Radharani.
So, 有时候奉献者会怀疑说，我们是不是也要来唱着 Radharani 的名字？
Srila Prabhupada explains, well, we are chanting Hare Krishna, and Hare Krishna is none different from Radha Krishna.
那 Prabhupada 说，我们也是在唱着 Hare Krishna， 唱着 Radha Rani 的名字，像我们在唱着念着 Hare Krishna 的时候，这个时候就有 Radha Rani 的在了。
Now in the whole Srimad Bhagavatam, we do not find the name of Srimati Radharani ever mentioned.
在整部国家晚堂里面呢，我们找不到 Radha Rani 这个字。
And sometimes devotees wonder why is it like this that she is so important.She's such a very, very special personality. She's so dear to Lord Krishna. Why is she not mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam?
So有时候奉献者就会觉得奇怪，为什么呢 ？Radha Rani 是这么重要，那为什么在整部国家瓦坛里面都没有看到她的名字
？So the acharyas describe that Sukadeva Goswami, who was narrating the Srimad Bhagavatam.He did not want to utter her name because he knew that if he would utter her name, it would arouse ecstasy. His bhava within his body would be awakened and he would not be able to continue reciting the Srimad Bhagavatam.
So Acharya 他们解释说呢，当这 Sukadeva Goswami 在讲述国家瓦坛的时候呢，他不想提出或是念出 Radha Rani 的名字，因为一旦 Radha Rani 的名字他的名字音这一出来，就没办法控制那种狂喜，他不想要这样子。
However, they do appreciate that Sukadeva Goswami mentioned her name in a disguised manner when he used the word aradhanam. Aradhanam means worshipping.
然后呢，这 Acharya 们还是非常感激 Sukadeva Goswami 有间接的提出 Radha Rani 的名字，叫 aradhanam。就是崇拜的意思。
So that personality who is the most expert in worshipping the Lord, this is Srimati Radharani.
所以那个最擅长去崇拜主的人就是 Radha Rani.
So all the people of Vrindavan, they are all very much devoted to Srimati Radharani because they know that by her blessings they can get the blessing of Krishna.
所以呢，在 Vrindavan 的人呢，都是这么非常的崇拜的 Radha Rani， 因为他们知道呢，得到 Radha Rani 的祝福呢，他们才可以所以得到 Krishna。
Then the verse goes, the song goes on. O you who dress yourself in such a way as to increase Lord Damodar's love and attraction for you.
所以呢，接着又有说到 Rupa Goswami 说 Radha Rani 装扮的这样子呢，让这个 主达摩达越来越受到他的吸引。
Lord Krishna is all attractive himself, but he is attracted by the pure love of Srimati Radharani.
那啊 ，Krishna 本人就是最迷人的人，但是他自己却受到 Radharani 的吸引，被他着迷了。
So it's mentioned to Damodara Rati that she could attract Lord Krishna, Lord Damodara.
所以这里就称呼 Radharani 是 Damodara Rati， 就是说他是可以吸引 Krishna， 吸引了 Damodara 的人。
Damodara Rati, there's a pastime where Lord Krishna was late. He was supposed to meet Srimati Radharani, and he came late.
曾经有个小小时光呢，这 Krishna 跟 Radharani 约会，那一次 Krishna 竟然迟到了。
So that time, Srimati Radharani bound up Lord Krishna.
那一次 Radharani 就把 Krishna 绑起来了。
Just like Mother Yashoda also tied up Lord Krishna, Srimati Radharani also tied up Lord Krishna.
就像这个啊，亚瑟达母亲把 Krishna 绑起来，这 Radharani 把 Krishna 绑起来。
Only by pure love can one bind up Krishna.
只有纯粹的爱才可以有办法把 Krishna 捆绑起来。
So Srimati Radharani, she has this pure love that she can also bind up Krishna.
那圣 Radharani 对 Krishna 纯粹的爱，所以她才有办法把所以把 Krishna 绑起来。
Then it's mentioned, O Queen of Lord Hari's Pleasure Grove, Vrindavan, which is pleasure grove of Lord, O Queen of Lord Hari's pleasure grove, Vrindavan, which is pleasure grove of Lord Hari. So Vrindavan is being described as the most pleasing place of Lord Krishna's pastime.
所以呢 ，Vrindavan 是被描述到是 Krishna 最快乐的逍遥时光进行的地方。
Lord Krishna is the king there, the ruler there in Vrindavan, and his queen is Srimati Radharani.
Krishna is Vrindavan 里面的所谓主宰者、控制者，也是那边的国王一样。那他的皇后呢是 Radharani.
Then Rupa Goswami continues, O new moon, who arisen from the ocean of King Vrishabhanu, O friend of Lalita, O you who make Vishakha loyal to you,due to your wonderful qualities of friendliness, kindness, and faithfulness to Krishna.
所以啊，这个 Rupa Goswami 就一直的描述着，就是说他是 Vrishabhanu 王的，对 Vrishabhanu 来讲呢 ，Radharani 就是海洋升起的新月一样，也是 Lalita 的朋友，也是最有美的 Vishakha 的快乐。
So just like when the demigods and the demons were churning the ocean of milk to get the nectar, they produced the moon. At one point they produced the moon from the ocean of milk.
所以当半神人们跟这个恶魔在这个牛奶海洋里面去对抗在搅的时候呢，在这样进行的时候就产生了月亮。
So here Rupa Goswami says the new moon has come from the ocean of King Vrishabhanu.
在这里呢 ，Rupa Goswami 说这个新月呢是从这 Vrishabhanu 的海洋所升起。
Vrishabhanu, of course, that meaning the father of Lord, the father of Srimati Radharani, the ruler of Varshana.
所以 Vrishabhanu 呢，当然就是 Radharani 的父亲，也就是 Varshana 的国王。
Then Srimati Radharani has many friends among the cowherd girls, and one of her closest friends is Lalita.
那 Radharani 有非常多的牧牛姑娘是她的朋友，其中一个是 Lalita.
There are many, many, countless numbers of gopis, and among them 108 are very important.
在牧牛姑娘们有无数无数的，那有其中100个是最主要的。
And among these 108, 8 are very significant, very prominent.
是108位，在这108位之中有几个是特别显著的。
Tungavidya, Chitra, Champakalata, Lalita, Vishakha, Indulita, Rangadevi, and Sudevi.
就是那八个主要的牧牛姑娘 Konga Vidya, Lalita, Vishaka, Ranga.
So Lalita is a very good friend of Srimati Radharani.
Lalita 呢是 Radharani 一个非常要好的朋友。
And Vishaka is very loyal to her.
Vishaka 呢对 Radharani 非常的忠诚。
And the reason why she's loyal is because she's so impressed by the wonderful qualities which Srimati Radharani possesses.
为什么他那么忠诚呢？是因为他对 Radharani 那么美好的品质。
Important qualities for a woman, very important qualities, friendliness.
尤其一些特质对女孩子特别重要，一个是友善。
Kindness.
仁慈。
And being faithful.
而且是信诚，忠诚。
Especially faithfulness to Krishna.
特别是对 Krishna 有信心。
So Srimati Radharani has all these qualities.
那 Radharani 是有这些所有这些品质。
You who are filled with compassion.
然后就说到 Radharani 是充满了仁慈。
Compassion very important.
非常的怜悯，对人的生物的怜悯是非常重要的。
You whose divine characteristics are described by the great sages Sanaka and Sanatan.
他 Radharani 的这么神圣的品质受到圣人 Sanakan 跟 Sanatan 的荣耀。
So Sanaka and Sanatana, they're two of the four sons of Brahma, the four Kumaras, the first sons of Brahma.
Sanakan 跟 Sanatan 呢是 Brahma 的四个孩子之中的两个。
So we can just understand the supreme position of Srimati Radharani, that she's such a exalted personality that her qualities are praised by even these great sons of Lord Brahma who are brahmacharis.
所以我们可以知道呢，这个 Radharani 是这么特别的，而且连那个像 Brahma 的孩子这么崇高的地位都在称赞 Radharani。
And they're brahmacharis, right? The four sons of Brahma, the four Kumaras, their lifetime brahmacharis. They vowed they would not get old.
然后呢 ，Brahma 的这个四个孩子呢，都是非常贞洁的贞守生，而且呢，一辈子贞守，而且呢，被祝福，永远不会变老。
Although they're the oldest, they're the oldest after Lord Brahma. They're the oldest people in the universe, but.They praise the qualities of Srimati Radharani.
虽然他们这四个孩子呢，是所谓在宇宙中被祝福是最长寿、最古老的生物，但是呢，他们这么特别，还是要去荣耀称赞这 Radharani.
And so Rupa Goswami then praised, oh most merciful Radha.Please be merciful to me.
Rupa Goswami 又接着去祈祷，就对 Radharani 说，你是最仁慈的人，请你来对我仁慈。
Now Rupa Goswami, in his spiritual body, he is Rupa Manjari. He is one of the young girls who assist the gopis, like Lalita and Vishaka and Srimati Radharani.
Rupa Goswami 在灵性世界呢是。Rupa Manjari, 她是呢很小的女孩子来协，她是很年轻的小女孩来协助那些牧牛姑娘们做服务的。
The Manjaris render the most confidential service to Radha and Krishna, to the divine couple.
Manjari 他们呢是来服务 Krishna, Radha 跟 Krishna 非常机密的服务。
So Rupa Goswami is praying like this to Srimati Radharani.That please bestow your mercy on me.
So Rupa Goswami 就对 Radharani 来祈祷说，请求他说啊，请你给我祝福。
So this day of the appearance day of Srimati Radharani is the most important day practically in the whole year. It's even more important for us than the day of Lord Krishna.
所以这个 Radharani 的显现日这样的日子呢是非常非常重要的日子，甚至我们可以说它比 Krishna 的显现日还来得重要。
Right, 2 weeks back we celebrated Krishna Janmashtami. And now we've come to Radhastami. It's also the eighth day of the moon, but it's 2 weeks after Krishna's appearance, and it's the appearance of Krishna's divine consort, Srimati Radharani.
2个礼拜前呢，我们庆祝主 Krishna 的显现日。那经过这样2个礼拜之后呢，我们现在庆祝 Radharani 的显现日。同样就是说，在一个是新月，一个是就是一个是月圆月缺的，正好都是在第八天的时候。
So we can see the very special position of Srimati Radharani, that she is the pleasure which she has in Krishna's pastimes is even greater than the pleasure of Lord Krishna himself.
那这 Radharani 是非常特别的，她的 Radharani 她所拥有的喜乐呢，是胜过于 Krishna 的喜乐。
And because Srimati Radharani is enjoying more than Krishna, then this causes Lord Krishna to come again in the mood of a devotee.
Because Radharani's 喜乐是那么多，而胜过 Krishna， 那么让 Krishna 吸引着，所以 Krishna 一直想要再过来，所以让他再出现。
He thinks, why should she enjoy more than me?So he wants to come. Krishna comes again in the mood of, he wants to cultivate this mood of Srimati Radharani, and he wants to cultivate this bhava which Srimati Radharani has for Lord Krishna.
So Krishna 就在想要再次显现出来。然后呢，他想要来教导、传扬这样对 Radharani 的这种 Bhava 这种深刻的爱。
And this is why Lord Krishna came in the Kali Yuga as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那这就是为什么 Krishna 在卡利年代出现为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
As it is commonly said, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya, the Lord Krishna Chaitanya.Mahaprabhu is the combined form of Srimati Radharani and Lord Krishna.
这个就是说了呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是Radharani 跟 Krishna 的结合。
That he is Krishna, but he has come in the mood of Srimati Radharani.
他是 Krishna， 但是他以圣 Radharani 的心境出现。
Therefore, we see Lord Krishna is a blackish color.But when he comes to Srimati Radharani, he comes in this golden color.
所以呢，我们知道呢，像 Krishna 的肤色是黑色的，但是呢，他想 Radharani 的心境出来的时候呢，他身体的颜色就是 Radharani 的金色的。
Because Srimati Radharani, she has this golden bodily complexion.
因为是 Radharani， 她有金色的这个皮肤。
Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi.Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hare. That Srimati Radharani comes, she has a golden complexion, and she comes as a daughter of Maharaj Vrishabhanu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants to experience this mood of Srimati Radharani.
Radharani 她带着金色的肤色，然后她出现在这 Vishvabhanu 国王的家里。那主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，就以 Radharani 的心境再次显现，而是呈现 Radharani 一样的肤色。
Therefore, he is constantly chanting the holy names of Krishna.
因此呢，他就一直唱诵着 Krishna 的圣名。
And just as Lord Krishna was dancing in Rasa Lila.The same way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was performing Sankirtan.
就像 Krishna 在 Rasa 舞蹈里面持续的舞蹈，那这个主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是持续的在唱诵圣名。
So it's a parallel pastime. What Lord Krishna was doing in the Dwapara Yuga, in the Rasa Lila, is performed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in performing Kirtan.
所以呢。 这个跟Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 跟 Krishna 的这个像时光的 Rasa 舞蹈的多巴胺那个年代是同时进行，那这个年代的时候是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 持续的唱诵圣名。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was constantly going everywhere, giving everyone the holy name and dancing and chanting, performing the Sankirtan, because he knew that by this chanting and dancing,then people could awaken their love for Krishna and they could experience also this attraction for Krishna.
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 就是说，处处去宣扬，处处去引介人们来念诵圣名，那就是，让每个人去品味，去体验到这唱诵圣名。
So, Srila Prabhupada was very cautious.about speaking about the matters of Srimati Radharani because it is certainly the most elevated topic.
那圣巴巴是非常小心的去谈到这个关于圣Radharani 的事，因为这是非常重要，也是很机密的话题。
When Srila Prabhupada published the Krishna book, his book which is called Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead,in which he describes the pastimes of Lord Krishna, both in not only in Vrindavan, but also in Dwarka and Mathura. So in the introduction to this book, Prabhupada brings up the topic, how people may ask, who is this woman with Krishna?
当 Prabhupada 在出版这个 Krishna, 自知人格守神这本书的时候，在前面的地方呢，包括他有特别提到，就是说人们会问，常常会问到说，那个 Krishna 跟 Krishna 在一起那个特别的女子是谁
？So although Prabhupada raised the question in the introduction, he never actually answered the question because he considers it to be a very confidential topic.
那在这个 Krishna 那本书里面的介绍的部分，包括他自己提出这个问题的，但是。他并没有去回答，因为这个话题、这个主题是非常机密的。
If one has not understood his own identity as a spiritual soul, then he will never be able to understand the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
因为呢，一个人如果不了解自己是灵魂的身份的话，他就没有办法了解 Radha 跟 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
If we want to understand Radha and Krishna, we have to go through the Goswamis.Of Vrindavan, like Rupa Goswami, we have to follow their teachings.
So, if we want to understand Radha and Krishna, we have to follow these Goswami, like Vrindavan, these six Goswami, like Rupa Goswami, they.
Just like in Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami has given us the essence of instructions, and he's described also, he's glorified the importance of Radha Kund and the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
就好像在《父爱的甘露》里面 ，Rupa Goswami 也介绍了像这个Radha Krishna， 还有这个 Radha 湖Krishna 湖的这一些逍遥时光的美。
But that's at the end of his teachings. The beginning of his teaching is that first of all you have to control the mind and senses.
关于这个 Radha Krishna Radha 湖这些事情呢，是在。奉爱的甘露最后面才讲，最开始是提到呢，一个人绝对要控制他的心意，控制他的感官，这些开始。
If one has not learned to master the urges of the senses and the mind and the reactions of anger, then we will never be able to understand the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
如果一个人没有办法很擅长的控制自己的心意，控制自己的感官，控制自己的这一些各种情绪脾气的话呢，让的人是无法了解 Radha Krishna 的这些逍遥时光。
So we want generally for public presentations that we speak more about the importance of controlling the mind and senses and purifying our consciousness. Then we can go on to try to understand.Who actually is Lord Krishna, and who is this lady who is with him?
So, in the interaction with the public and the preaching and the direct teaching, we are definitely to emphasize control of the mind, control of the senses, 然后呢间接在就是再来带进去说在 Krishna 这身边的这个女子是谁，为什么她这么重要。
Maybe my god brothers would like to say something.
也许我的神兄弟想要说一些什么。
Prabhupada Prabhu, Sivananda Prabhu.
No, you're doing fine. You're doing great.
Is Hari Bhakti one? Is he ready to chant?
Yeah.
It's Abhishek. Now it's Abhishek. Okay, so we will stop now. We'll have the Abhishek. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.